Well, I don't interpret anything that somebody else says. See, that's a part of the code. That includes Dr. Francis Wilson. Bless her soul. And so, in her absence, I cannot editorialize anything that she has said or written. And I have been, you know, in her presence many times. And even when I made presentations while she was here, we always made our presentations separate so that people could evaluate what is being said on its own merits.
Okay.
In other words, what comes from Dr. Wilson came from Dr. Wilson. And since she has passed on now, I definitely would not want to be the person who starts trying to interpret what she meant when she said anything. I might have my own ideas about it and all like that, but these are my ideas, but I would not voice them to anybody because that would not be doing the correct thing where she is concerned. That's why I'm saying, while people are here on this planet, try to express everything that you have to say while you're here and try to express it in such a way that everybody understands exactly what you meant so that there's not what when you're gone.
Confused, yes.
And that includes Neely Fuller. I mean, I try to clear up everything that I say. That's why I talk so long in answer to a question. I mean, sometimes people say, well, I'm answering the question over and over again.
Yes.
I'm trying to ingrain this. This is the viewpoint that I have so that after I'm gone, because I know how fast confusion can come up. People can say, well, I know what Fuller meant. You know, I know something about Fuller. I mean, I talked to him and all like that, and on and on and on. And next thing you know, it'll be nowhere close to what I meant. Okay? So I am very cautious in doing this, and I am telling everybody to be very cautious in making interpretations that you pass on from one person to another about what somebody else said.
All righty.
Have your own interpretation.
Yes, sir.
And act on it if it's of any value to you.